Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to do the beauty scenario tag. I saw It's Judy Time do this tag, so I wanted to go ahead and do it for myself because it seemed like a lot of fun. And I'm gonna go ahead and tag all of you guys right now. If you wanna do this tag, then go ahead. It's always fun to do these tag videos to see what everyone comes up with. So the first question is, you have to get rid of all your foundations and you can only keep one high-end and one drugstore. Which do you keep? Well, this one was kind of hard for me because I actually like a lot of drugstore foundations, but if I had to keep only one, I really, really couldn't choose between these two. I love them both equally the same, and I just couldn't choose between them, so I'm gonna include both of them. And the first one is the True Match Lumi Foundation, which I've been using a lot in a lot of my tutorials recently. And the reason why I like this is because it goes on lightweight, it has really good coverage, and it gives my skin that nice glow, which I really, really love. It makes it less cakey looking, and so I really like this. And my shade in the True Match is the N1/2 Neutral. And then I also really, really love the Revlon Colorstay Whipped. This is just a great, great product. It is really high coverage and it goes on really smooth. It doesn't feel like a lot of makeup. And then it also gives you a nice dewy look to your skin too. It doesn't look cakey and it lasts a really, really long time. I don't think it's 24 hours. I've never worn my makeup that long, so I couldn't tell you. But this one is 240 Natural Beige. And for my high-end foundation, I love the Lock It Tattoo Foundation by Kat Von D. This one is in the shade L48. Again, it's high coverage, it goes on smooth. This one is a matte finish, so it doesn't have a dewy finish to it, but I like matte finish for when I'm going out at night. And usually when you go out, you either go dancing or you're at a wedding or wherever it is and you're out dancing. I like this because when you sweat, you can get that dewy look even if you have a matte foundation. So I like the matte foundation for when I'm going out. And this one is awesome. The coverage is insane. It's total high coverage. It's gonna hide everything. The next question is, you go for an interview and the lady interviewing you has lipstick on her teeth. Do you approach the subject or ignore it completely? And to be completely honest, I would probably just ignore the situation because I'm not one to point things out because I feel embarrassed for the person. And the thing about me is that if I get embarrassed, I turn red. So it makes me even more embarrassed when that happens. So if someone was interviewing me and they had lipstick on their teeth and I pointed it out, I'd probably be embarrassed for them and get red, and it would just be a totally awkward situation for me. So I probably would just completely ignore it and act like I didn't notice it. Question three is, you're not feeling yourself and need a pick-me-up. Which lipstick do you put on to make yourself feel beautiful? I don't really like bright lipsticks, so I really gravitate towards nudes. I really love nude lipstick. To me, it makes my lips look a lot bigger. Even though that's not really a pick-me-up because it's nothing bright or anything like that, but my favorite neutral at the moment is Coquette by Lime Crime. It looks like this, and it's what I'm wearing today. And I just love this lipstick. It is super opaque, it's nice and creamy, it's not dry on your lips, but it gives you kind of a matte finish, and they smell like the MAC lipsticks, like kind of like that vanilla-y smell. And of course the packaging for Lime Crime is just so cute, and I guess the packaging itself is a little pick-me-up because there's a unicorn on it, it's glittery, and so I just love the Lime Crime lipsticks in general. Number four is, you go back in time for a day to your teenage years. How would you do your hair and makeup differently? My hair, I probably wouldn't change anything about my hair. It was just my natural hair color, which is kind of like a dark brown, kind of reddish tone. And it was kind of long with layers, so I don't think I would change anything about my hair. But as far as my makeup, I would definitely tell myself to put down the tweezers because a lot of times I overplucked my eyebrows and they were super thin and it was just not a good look. I definitely didn't know back in the day how important eyebrows were to the whole overall look of your face. And maybe that's why I'm so obsessed with them now, because it makes such a difference. And yeah, mine were super thin. It just looked all around bad. And if your eyebrows don't look good, then your overall look in general, like your whole makeup look, is not gonna look as nice as if your eyebrows were really nice and defined and, you know, kind of thicker. So some people can pull off the really thin eyebrow, but it did not look good on me. So that's definitely what I would tell myself. 5 is you ask your hairdresser for a shoulder length pixie lot haircut, but they hair wrong and give you a pixie cut. Do you A, smile, say thank you, leave and call your mom hysterical, B, cry in the chair and things get awkward, or C, complain to the manager and demand a refund? Well, I've had a lot of these type of scenarios in the past where I go and I get my hair done and it's not what I wanted. So all those times in the past, I just smile and tell them thank you and that I love it. And when I leave, I'm just complaining like, oh my God, they cut my hair, because I don't like people to feel bad. Like, I don't want them to, I just don't like that awkwardness where you're like, I don't like it. And so I just kind of pretend like I like it and then I leave. But you best believe I'm not going to go to that hairdresser ever again. And that's why now when I find somebody that I really like and they do a really good job, I just stick with that person. I don't go to anyone else. And shout out to my stylist, Tamara at Victoria Garden. She's amazing. And she did my new hair color. I'm sure you guys noticed it's purple now. And she's really great and patient, and she really cares about the overall outcome of your hair. And so I just go to her all the time because she does an amazing job. And that's just basically what I've done from now on. If I like somebody that does a service for me and they're really good, then I just go to that person always. If they do a bad job, then I'm not going to them again. And so it's happened to me a couple of times, and I just usually tell them thank you, and I just don't go see them ever again. 6 is your friend surprises you with a 4-day city break and you have 1 hour to pack. Which do-it-all palette do you pack in your makeup bag? Honestly, you really can't go wrong with the original Naked palette. I love this palette, all the shades in here. You can do a day to a night. So if it was a surprise and I had to like just get something really quick, it would definitely be the Naked palette, just because there's a little bit of mattes, mostly shimmers, and it's very versatile. And I just love the warm nude colors. So definitely can't go wrong with the Naked palette. It has a lot of colors in there. It's portable. And so yeah, it would definitely be the Naked palette. Okay, 7 is your house has been robbed. Don't worry, everyone is safe, but your beauty stash has been raided. What's the product you really hope is safe? And that one would be my contour kit by Anastasia. I love this kit. I use it literally every single day, even if I'm wearing like a day look or a more evening look, it doesn't matter. I am using this because I just love the way it makes my face look. I like the nice defined cheekbones. I like the contour of my nose. And honestly, I just don't think my makeup looks as nice anymore unless I use this. It's just a must now. And I really love every single shade from the palette. I use this one a lot for the contour of my nose. I love the highlight. I like the setting or highlighting powders here. So I just love this, and it is definitely a must. If you love the contour look, you have to get this. And the last question is 8. Your friend borrows your makeup and returns it in awful condition. Do you A, just pretend you haven't noticed, B, ask them to repurchase it, or C, secretly do the same to something of theirs? I probably would say, like, were you drunk when you used this? Or, you know, like something along the lines that's kind of funny, but you get your point across, so they know that you're like, what the hell did you do with my palette? But I definitely wouldn't wouldn't just pretend like nothing happened. And then I definitely wouldn't feel right to just ask them to buy it again. And then I'm not very spiteful with makeup, so I wouldn't do anything to theirs. But I would definitely kind of say something along those lines, like, what the hell were you doing when you were using this? Like, what the hell? But yeah, so that's what I would do. I would make it kind of funny, but still get my point across, and then probably not give it them any of my other makeup products after that, because yeah, they can't be trusted. So that's it. That is the tag. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And of course, you guys are all tagged. And if you like these videos, then I will definitely do some more. Comment below if you have any other tag videos that you want me to do. And as always, thank you guys for watching my videos, and I will see you in the next one.